We started the Mosaic Project 5 years ago as a community awareness project. We distribute almost 400 canvases each year, 80% artists and 20% community members. We creatively connect by doing a canvas, and some of them are painted, some of them are quilt, that reflect the beauty of the Florida Keys. So we don't have a theme, except for that they're going to be connected. My piece is of a Key West sunset. I was walking home and I took a photograph of this really beautiful pinky purpley sky. And then I went to one of the Key West free workshops and I had some real artists help me.
We start with the first reception in Key Largo and work our way down Isla Mirada, Marathon, Big Pine, and then Key West. And people get to see other artists' work from up and down the Keys and really integrates us and makes us learn about our fellow artists that might live 100 miles away. And it really is exciting. It's kind of like a treasure hunt. There isn't a map to it. You have to look at all the canvases in order to find your own. I do encaustic painting, which is painting with wax on wood surfaces. So I took the canvas off, put a wood panel on, and I did a hibiscus this year in honor of Chris Sandifer, our beloved originator of this project.
For my art, I mean, it's, you know, this is why we live here. It's the Keys. It's our little piece of paradise. It's three palm trees, water, clouds, and reflection on the water. I'm just nothing but proud. This, I think, is the only project that we all collaborate or connect on. There are always the key shots, but what I'm seeing more and more of are the fun things. Things that are pasted on the canvas, the beads, the little leg of a doll sticking out, the watches, just the humorous things.
Each piece is unique and has the flair of that artist, what's in their mind. It's a catalyst for conversation for the viewer and for the artist. My piece represents the area around us. One of the pieces I did were frangipanis in a glass and a vase bowl. The other was a stone crab claw because I think they're really indicative of why people come to the Keys.
This year I chose a local scene, which is the Lorelei, and that is in Isla Mirada. One of the areas that I really like is where the little dinghies come in, and I happened to capture a scene that has the birds sitting there on each post. I am a plein air artist, and this year, each plein air artist was given a canvas and asked to paint. So what's so exciting to me is that amongst the canvases that you might have someone who's never painted before, and you might have someone that little canvas is probably worth a lot of money, and that you can get a piece of art that will touch your heart forever.
This program here is chaired with producing more money for the grants in the schools, and that's what we try to raise money for that purpose. I did a loggerhead turtle. In this community, we have a turtle hospital, which gives a lot of the turtles rescue. It's a great, great image. And if you've ever been diving, and if you see a turtle in the water, they are just so amazing. Good quality artists, really, really good quality. So it's exciting.
The impact of a 24-foot long, 4-foot high piece of art that's made up of almost 400 different people's artwork is just inspiring.